The new Corona version came out, and today I present to you the main features. It's the huge news for all the Vantage users and the flagship feature of the Corona 12. Now the plugin supports exporting to Vantage. I show you this on the scene from our visualization training. In the System tab, you'll find the new options. You can export your Corona scenes in VR scene format and open them in Vantage. You can now choose between CPU and GPU rendering workflows based on your needs. When you import the scene, you can explore it in real time. We can adjust the scene, render the images, or create animations. Obviously, the results won't be as good as in Corona, but it might be good enough for scene exploration or test renders. The Corona team claims that the next stage will be the Corona and Vantage integration with a live link between the tools. It is supposed to be there in the next Corona version. We have a totally new look for frame buffer. It's simpler and more minimalistic. The features are similar and pretty easy to find, so I'm sure you won't have any issues with that. But the really cool feature we've got here is the possibility to get various light mix setups. So now, we can create various lighting scenarios without the need to create a separate file, if everything else stays more or less the same, of course. Basically, we have to add a new light mix render element. We can create, for instance, day and night lighting scenarios. We can create various lighting scenarios and edit just one file. And when we change one light mix, it doesn't influence another one. Another thing is improved A-B image comparison in the History tab. We can compare the images not only with different resolutions, but also with various aspect ratios. We can, for example, quickly check if we like more horizontal or square format. Also, we can now use the new option in Bloom and Glare, the Compute After Render option. We can speed up the process by choosing to delay the calculation of Bloom and Glare until the end of the render. Instead of turning off and on the effect, we can just click the option. We are able to drag and drop the CXR file into the VFB itself and immediately continue editing it. Finally, we can use the new gamma, lift and green parameters in the tone mapping. However, lift gamma values should be set to 1 if you want to get correct results and compose render elements together. There is a new option in the chaos scatter that allows us to edit instances manually. Here we have the communicate that there is more instances in reality than displayed, but I won't worry about it here, as I only want to show you how it works. If we want, we can change the displayed settings. We can choose from two options, brush and erase. Let's start with the erase. With the brush, we can manually delete certain instances. We can adjust the brush if we need to. On another hand, we can also add instances manually with the brush. We can either follow scattering rules or not. If this option is not checked, we can, for instance, paint outside of specified areas or avoid some rules like avoid collision, slope limitation, or camera clipping. I like to have this option here as sometimes it's very handy to do things manually in the scatter. Corona Sky was improved. It supports lower angles for the sun below the horizon. We can go down up to minus 12 degrees compared to the previous minus 4.2 degrees. There is also a new option in the clouds called density scaling. By increasing the value, we can make the clouds more dense, looking more heavy, more stormy. On the other hand, by decreasing the value, we can make them more thin, which results in a more delicate look. It's always good to have more control over the sky's appearance. We have new parameters in Corona Decals too. They allow us to bend a decal object to get nice results on the rounded and curved objects, such as bottles. Thanks to that, we'll not get distortions and we can ideally adjust the objects. We can bend the decals up to 360 degrees to map a pattern around an object. It can be bent around the second axis too, would allow us to add decals to spherical objects like balls, balloons and more. Additionally, they added a toggleable lock button that locks the width to height aspect ratio for the decal. If you're using Corona Pattern, it has an extra option that will help with defining the shape of the crop box. Now we can use geometry objects as a helper. Thanks to that, we can adjust the vertices easily with the snapping tools, for instance. This way, we can create some holes, seams, and so on. We have also a new option in the UV mode, alternate path. It takes UVW mapping from the base object or the pattern depending on the texture channel. There are also some smaller improvements. For instance, having the Corona material library in Chaos Cosmos, so we don't have to switch between assets libraries. If you want to learn how to create beautiful visualizations in 3ds Max and Corona, join our course. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more of my videos. Bye!